Tell me like a Hellcat.
Hey guys, welcome back to Aspirant Gaming, and you all remember Jenny Maddox, right? Well, she got her story saved by a bunch of people giving her loads of money and a house and things, and she had a bit of a job to try and normalize things again, and I want to bring her back to her roots as homeless Jenny. Well, that means this has got to go. So I hired our resident accident man, Raphael, to come and make me go away. So I'm going to put something on here to make sure I don't explode in a ball of... Well, you'll find out in a second, but... Terrible accidents could happen near runways, right? Yeah. Okay, do you have a plane ready?
Yep. I'm going to be landing and sliding.
Okay, you're landing. Okay.
Well, I'm going to spawn in the sky somewhere, obviously.
Okay, yeah. Huh, this is one of those one-shot deals, dude. We have to get this one right.
Yeah, that's why I put plane on God mode.
No, this is a one-shot deal. You got to hit this right. I need it full-on smacked so I can just go kaboom. I want to see what happens to this. We'll roleplay out whatever happens. But,
well,
Jenny's home has to go bye-bye in the worst way possible. No, the nice trailer's been good, but at the same time, I really want it to be a little bit worse off. I need to bring back Jenny to her roots, because people just power gamed me so hard and basically made her life perfect. It had to change. You know where I'm at, right? On the this end, the Grapeseed Main Street end?
Yeah, I teleported to you.
Okay, cool. I'm kind of nervous. I want to see how this goes. Fire will not be expecting this,
man,
I can tell you that. I think I hear you, or I don't. I'm not sure. Oh, no, I see you. Oh, God, this is fast. Oh, and there goes that. Okay, fire will hopefully notice their call, though. Oh, bugger. The Stukas are diving. Oh. That is a miss. It's a solid miss. That was a huge miss. Yes? You didn't even touch
your RV?
Me. Yeah.
I'm right here at your RV.
Oh, that was... No, you might need to do that again, because I didn't get hit. You flew past me in my eyes.
I'm literally at your RV.
Yeah, I know you are, but you didn't hit me in my eyes. You just literally flew past me that appeared underneath me. The desync was strong.
Miss.
Oh, yeah. No, I believe you, but that was amazing desync. I think anybody watching that will know that was amazing desync. It was like, one minute you just cruised happily over me. You bounced off the runway, flew over me, and then just appeared next to me.
Yeah, I hope one thing increases that.
Hopefully it should, but that was, that's one of those moments of 5M, I think.
Take two.
Yep, take two. Why is it every time I try and do an accident, we've got to do multiple takes now, nothing goes right? I just want to make it interesting for people responding to it, you know? Alright, here we go. The sun's coming out, so it's a good omen.
I'm
not quite. Should I move this a bit, make it easier to hit?
Yeah, because that bump fucked me.
Yeah,
is
I got you.
Around?
No.
I sure the hell hope not.
I hope not either, but we should be okay. Nobody would be... the pilot at me says I shouldn't park right here on the end of the runway. But I'm gonna.
I mean... Yeah.
Jenny would know that. Okay. Is this better?
I'll just use landing wheels this time.
Yeah, just have the wheels down.
Say I came in too hot or something.
Yeah, you just run over the end. It makes sense. It would work. I'm just chilling here. No big deal. I hope he gets it this time. I really do. I just think the screw-ups are half the fun with these videos. They really are. Here we go. Oh, I hope this works. Oh, Oh, it's kind of good. Kind of in a way. Yep. Oh, okay. Why am I upright? That's one way for it to happen. Yeah?
I took you in a ditch.
You did? I'm upright, which is kind of weird, but there you go.
Well, you was upside down, but...
I was upside down, then it could have went back upright again. Stay here. I'll be right back.
You could probably bounce right off the plane.
I need to be in the driver's seat. Just stay here. I gotta go do some magic. The power of Chilliad compels me. The power of Chilliad will help this. It needs to be more broken, okay? We're making this authentic for them to look at.
I slammed to the side of your thing like I accelerated.
Yeah.
GTA.
Oh my god. This thing is so messed up right now.
What the fuck? This thing is fucked.
I think my engine's dead, which might mean I can't actually have to go anywhere, but we'll work with that.
Oh, you can, I believe.
No, because it floats when you do that.
Oh, that's right.
Damn.
So
I have to repair it. It's so stupid.
If somebody comes by, it's like...
I know. I feel so bad about this. It's gonna be so great.
Okay.
Okay, though. That kind of works. We can go with that. Yeah? Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. This is definitely not a good option for them. Okay, I'll put a call in. No, I need to put...
Want fire? Do we not want fire?
Yeah. No fire. We'll put some smoke in, but we'll not put fire in. Let me just put a call in from,
I'll probably do 10x10, that sounds good.
Yeah, just do 10x10 smoke.
Yeah. I'm gonna freeze my vehicle so I don't have to hear that scraping.
Yeah, I'll do that to mine too. Okay, we made it work in the end. It's not quite as borked as I was hoping for, but it'll do, you know?
Why is it
it'll
scraping?
Do. Because mine isn't frozen. Now it is. No more scrape?
You would have died in that realistic.
I'm going to be messed up and trapped in the metal, twisted metal, okay? Oh, someone sees it. Okay, we're good. I need to quickly move seats.
Hope he didn't see the three planes crashing.
I hope he didn't see the three planes crashing. It looks like Jake, so we should be okay. Oh, God. Yeah, it is Jake. I hope he didn't see all this scuffery. I don't care. Jacob know what we're doing. Jake knows if people are setting stuff up to ignore it, you know. He's good like that. So fire should probably be diving for attack channel right now. I hope. As long as we
sir, can you hear me?
Are you gonna be conscious or not?
Sir.
Yeah.
I don't think they'll notice me in the RV till later on. Which is good. That's what I'm going for. You be the main focus of this until they spot me. Oh, I heard someone pull up. It's a random biker. Random lost biker turned up, but they're driving off. Are you being unconscious or...?
Well, I'm trying to talk in game, but...
You're not answering.
No, yeah. Of course Mike wants to...
Sir.
It's going so well. It's going great. Should I speak for you?
No, let's see. There we go.
There you go. There you go.
I got the runway. I got the runway on me.
God damn it. I wish we could damage vehicles more in this game. It looks so cool.
If only we had Beeman G crashes.
I know.
This would look so amazing. Plane parts would be everywhere.
Yeah, the RV basically torn in half. It'd be great. Here's fire.
Do you speak English?
Of course I speak English.
This mic's being weird. Oh well.
Okay. Do you have any pain right now? Where are you hurting at?
Oh, man.
No one can see me.
Hey, do you think I missed the runway?
Yeah, you did, buddy. That's at least you're worried right now.
It hurts.
Stable is the plane.
I don't know. I'm just checking him over.
The angle you're at is great.
Okay.
It actually couldn't fall.
Yeah, no, the angle.
Yeah, I haven't had a chance to check over the RV yet. I got the door here open on the plane.
Because your RV would be holding it.
So far, it looks like he's got cuts to his head.
We best get rid of this because the rain wouldn't dump down any smoke.
Yeah, you want me to do it or you got it?
I got it. Yeah, the rain and get rid of the smoke, so.
It's only smoke from the dust. Should be all cleared now, anyways, really. Of course it does.
Yeah, of course it chooses now to thunder. It could be any time in the world, but every time I try and do
see,
a scene,
you're right,
boom, comes the thunder.
Never want to run.
I mean, this is atmospheric at least.
Yeah,
we can
looks...
go with that. It's at least atmospheric. We probably have to both talk up a little bit as it gets worse, but...
Oh man.
Fix that there. I love how Fyra is just standing back and letting Jake do all this. Oh, I see a Porky. Pork authority turned up.
Okay, hey guys. He's trapped in here.
Okay,
really, it would have been
assuming by the fact that it's relatively stable.
Yeah, well, I haven't had the plane shift on me, and I'm not burned alive, so. Hey, buddy, you're gonna be okay. You stay with me, alright?
I can't wait for one thing, it'll fix all
what
these audio issues.
I said I see the light.
Hey, no, man, stay with me.
Is the plane leaking, Raph?
Well, realistically, probably fuel, oil.
Hey, can I have one of you guys come over here? I can't really do anything.
Yeah. Keep it safer.
Yeah, I'll swap with you.
Yeah, and then I'm gonna cross.
Yeah, no, you're good. I'm swapping out for you.
Now they're all talking at once. Great.
He's trapped at the legs. He's got to his head.
Goddamn fire.
So, say again, trapped at the legs and has injury to his head.
Got cuts on his head.
Oh, be that thing.
Yeah.
Hello, sir. My name is Paramedic Jones, San Andreas Fire and Rescue. How you you doing alright in there?
Lieutenant, do you think we could volley for an additional... Hey, how I'm doing?
With one trapped in the back. Hey.
Getting
out of the
medic.
I'm there. I can head to the back of the
army. Hey, I got spreaders right now if they're entrapped.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, I got a CD. The best approach to get in the back. Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, I'm just gonna give you a quick check over.
The best approach may be through one of these trenches.
Can give us something more realistic here. Tangled metal.
I'm not sure. Oh.
Medic.
You can. Oh shit.
Oh.
What the hell? Oh.
trying. But
medic fell under the
RV.
Right there.
Nice. Okay, there's vents on the roof there.
My thoughts, back window, punch that, we can go through.
Hey, if you guys want, we probably bust out this back window and get access for you.
I mean, I have a glass breaker right on me.
Let's break this window.
Alright, I'll climb
first
in there.
First into foreign body, it's not gonna be that simple as going through the window.
Stand back, got a glass breaker.
Body bags. Oh wow, okay. You brought some party time.
Hey, would you mind getting some speed try and getting some under this RV? It's leaking fuel.
Well, I'm about to climb in there and try and get and check on this person unless you want to go in.
I'll head in.
Can't climb in. No.
Also, see if you can grab me an flash bag for my rescue.
Yep.
Hey, I don't think you're gonna have access back here. It's pretty bent.
Yeah, you can't climb in.
All right.
It's a bit harder for them.
All right.
I'm gonna see
simple.
That if we could cut to the roof.
Okay.
Make their lives harder. It's much more fun.
This place is stable, right?
Relatively.
I'm unsure. You gotta check with one of the other firemen.
278, yeah, that's secured and stable.
Alright.
How's the pilot been?
Okay, he's slightly entrapped under. Basically, the dash came in a little bit as it hit the RV, so he's probably very slightly trapped there.
Alright, instead of using spreader, let's use hydraulic ramp.
That makes sense.
Because it is actively leaking, yes, the dip is observing it, but I'm trying to minimize any spark.
Lieutenant, I have a fireman grabbing some speedy dry to throw on that fuel.
RV, and
he's also getting me an ALS bag and K-12.
The dip is observing it, but I'm trying to see if I can block the leak.
PA on main road. Okay, yeah.
She's not looking too good.
Yeah, I gotta wait until I get a K. I'm gonna have to get into the roof, which I'm waiting on a K-12 for.
The other guy's bringing you a K-12 right
get
now.
You out. Just start cleaning your head wound. All right. Check over you.
What if you have a spare ALS bag on you? Down here?
I have the other guy also grabbing it off rescue for you.
Let's say maybe a wheel's found.
Yeah, she
way.
Looks
she's
pretty torn up. I can't
nothing.
See her full body. She looks to be trapped by a cabinet or something.
Alright, once I get it through the roof, I can check further.
Yeah.
I'm saying, what if we say that a wheel's found? If they search the runway, they'll find like a wheel from the plane. That way, it's like why it careened off the runway sort of thing.
Yeah, we'll say like it came in landing too hard.
Yeah.
The wheel broke off.
Yeah.
We try to go into the rear window, but you can't really get access from there, so we're gonna cut a hole through the roof.
Yeah, I'm looking outside here to see if it's good enough shape or not.
Before we use anything that's sparked, let's try to figure out a way to stop the leaking.
Though the spark should be far enough away, but with the rain, it should also help us in terms of the fumes that can catch fire.
I'm gonna be seeing some try to see if you need to plug the leak.
I got a plug kit up here too. I'm just helping with these spreaders right now.
Cause LT need to get her out fast.
Okay, how do you want to get this person out, medic?
Point
they can get in the side, but it's time.
The one in the RV, we're gonna have to try to extract to the roof.
Hey, it look like hold on. I might be able to get access to the side here.
see what Jake can do.
LT. Okay. Can you run this plug kit down there so they can plug, get that fuel done?
Already grab something for it.
Atsu.
278, no matter what, okay. I'm still gonna have to cut a hole through the roof to extract her.
Here comes Atsu. I think.
Just to give you an update.
Here, let me see if I can get in there, that way I can shield her just from anything coming from that roof.
Yeah.
Okay, so what we're just going to do is we're going to gently spread the dash a little bit and we're going to get you out of here.
It's quieter in here.
We've applied some tourniquets to your legs just in case there's any cross injury. I've got a backboard nearby as well.
Did we put some
rescue
straps on the vehicle?
Yep,
we did.
Man, I can walk with my legs out of here. I mean, I can still feel them.
Okay, sir.
So, on the stretch on here, you're probably going to slip. We're all going to fall in the ditch.
Okay, well, let's see what happens. I'd rather carry you out if you can.
Right, I'm through.
I'm going to put the C-collar on you as well, just to keep you, because you have an impact injury.
Where is 187? How's the leak? Oh, good.
Where's my...
Hey, you're good to start
still
cutting.
Filming in the background. I see his white t-shirt.
All right.
Alright, guys. I'm just going to spam the door, alright? Keep talking to me. Let me know if you feel anything in your legs.
You see me to spread the dash?
Yeah, so I've just taken those from you and I'm just slowly doing
it'll
it.
It'll work.
Grab the backboard, we'll just use it to carefully extract outside. I'd rather carry him across the rocks.
Alright, did you grab a backboard when we got here? It's all ambo.
No, I think it's in ambo. If you can grab it while I'm just spreading, that'll be amazing. Thanks,
By cabinet.
Okay. All right, sir. You look to be free. I'm just gonna give you.
I'm also gonna need a backboard brought up here from the rescue.
Okay. Grab one.
You need anything 139?
I have a backboard coming, and then we'll basically need to extract this gentleman.
Cut leg from torn metal, unconscious, pale, and blow pulse.
Okay.
All right, I got the whole cut. I'm coming into you. I'm coming to you. I got the whole cut.
Yeah. Okay, be careful. Yeah, when you come in, make sure you don't put any pressure on that cabinet.
How low?
Yep, I'll do my best.
3. Pretty low. We're going off a D12
right,
or a D20.
How are you feeling?
I can't find
you're just
my
a little
D20.
Bit cut up. We're okay.
That word. This thing, I don't like sitting in the chair.
Fin up. Just waiting for the board to come. And what we're going to do is put you...
Alright, I'm in.
On the board and we'll carry you out and over.
Okay, I'm getting a ticket on her leg. She's got a real bad cut here.
Alright.
Oh, they are inside. Yeah. Okay, that's a scary angle.
Alright, sir, are you able to undo the buckle?
Oh. Let's get this cabinet off her.
Alex.
Yep.
From a head wound.
Okay, great. Alright, sir, what I'm going to do is I'm going to support you out. My colleague here will help you out as well. I'm just going to leave you, if you can lie on the backboard for me and we'll get you over the rocks. All rocks, right. Okay?
Hey, Rachel, do you mind if I string a Yasin?
It's fine. Yeah, just don't get too close because obviously it'll wake you up.
Okay, your pulse is pretty low.
Alright, thank you.
The bone and.
Oh, okay, alright.
Left leg, lateral.
All right, guys. Yep. So he's out. We'll just secure him down to the back.
Inches. That pulse is. Let's go for 42.
All right.
BP 82 over. Let's go for a 56.
All right. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna.
All right. I'm gonna get this
pass you over the rocks, and we're gonna come up to the ambulance. Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. Alright.
They're moving here.
Here we go, guys. Passing over.
Continue helping. 187, continue helping.
Here, I'll deal with her head wound while you're working on that.
We'll be able to hear now.
Yeah, if you could.
Help. 35.
I don't even see them.
Yeah, Lieutenant, I'm down in the RV.
Oh. Okay.
And it's cozy in the RV, and no rain.
How are you doing? Here's a backboard for you.
Right on Twitches.
Yeah,
And I'm also gonna quickly check if there's anything obvious. Spinal walk.
Yeah. While you do that, I'm gonna go ahead and get a line started. Since she's got pretty low vitals.
Oh, yep. I can't see anything obvious. I can't obviously
find
see
out
sure
once we.
Much.
Yeah, we'll have to find out once we get her up onto the. Berm.
Okay, her hand's twitching. Okay, so she's at least got movement, so that's good.
Yeah, she's got movement. There's there is still a possibility of spinal and neck injury, but if you could go ahead and grab a C collar from my bag and get it.
Why don't you try to talk to me?
Okay. Do you want me to do anything with your leg other than tourniquet? I already got the tourniquet on, but.
At this point, we could just wrap some gauze, clean it, and wrap some gauze on it.
Okay.
Hey, what do you need to verify?
Try and talk to me. A good start.
Put the back forward.
Yeah, she might be coming too soon.
Yeah. I gave her some atropine, so I should raise up her vitals a little bit, so that way she could hopefully come around.
Okay.
I also gave her some fluids. Hey, LT?
No one's talking to me still.
Yep.
Is there a way you could send somebody back over to grab an additional ambulance?
Our ambulance is coming back.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's ending.
At this time, we do have times one broken arm.
Sick as the NBA.
we also have a femoral artery hit on the left leg. We currently have that tourniqueted. We also have a head injury. We're currently stabilizing down here. IV started with some saline and atropine. We're getting her ready to get her up to you guys on the to the backboard.
No one's.
We're
no
just
one's
stabilizing her
me.
Down here before we move her.
Yeah.
We have done neck stabilization, unknown of spinal injuries at this time. She was underneath a cabinet that we had to move.
Come on, at least try and talk to me. When you get signs of potential consciousness, you are meant to basically be like, hello, can you hear
ma'am,
me?
Ma'am, can you hear me?
Yay.
I'll ask you a question after the scene. So
hello, ma'am, my name is Paramedic Duffy with the San Andreas Fire Rescue. I'm here to help you, alright?
Where am I? Where am I? What happened? Oh, it hurts. What happened? Then dead silence. Because dead silence. Because dead silence. I go to all the
right,
freaking
ma'am. Yeah, I've been in a bit of an accident. Alright, but we're here to take care of you, okay?
Really?
Yeah, it's like dead silence for like 10, 20 seconds, and eventually he replies. It's like, oh, cool, okay, dynamic.
Yeah, they just seem clueless.
Was parked. How could it be in an accident? That's just stressing.
278, let's try to get her up to ground.
How could it crash when
it was parked?
Down or up?
We're gonna bring her through the roof towards you. That's gonna be the better access to get her out. Because I have a nice sized hole cut through the roof.
That works. So I'm getting pulled out through the roof. That will work. Yeah, I don't really need the D20 today. But I gotta find the 20, so I'm using a D12.
Alright, ma'am, could you tell me your name?
Jenny, oh god, I hurt. What happened?
Well, it looks like a plane hit your RV.
What? Plane? Huh?
Yeah.
Why?
Don't worry, there's no fire. We took care of that already, alright? At this point, we're focused on getting you out.
Why do I hurt so much?
Don't worry. But yeah, if you could tell me your name, so we acted to you, okay?
Jenny. My name's Jenny.
Alright, Jenny, like I said, my name is Paramedic Duffy, alright? I'm here to get you out.
Conduct investigation. Discover a...
And right next to me, I have Fish and Wildlife helping me get you out, okay? And we have a nice crew of people on top that are going to help you get you out. Lieutenant, are we ready?
Yep, just waiting on you guys.
Alright. Alright, Jenny, what we're going to do is we're going to lift you through the roof, and I have a bunch of people on the top that are going to help get you onto a board.
That is the best.
And we're
going
to take you to the hospital, okay?
Okay.
Alright, 278 on my count.
Yep.
Alright, 1, 2, 3. Sending her up to you.
Be careful.
Yep, you should be very careful. Alright,
I already answered.
I'm gonna get a recheck on the vitals since I had given a little bit of atropine.
Must be tired.
I think medic already arrived.
Yeah.
Would one of you mind grabbing another check on the rest of the injuries that we've treated already?
It's coming up. It's not good yet, but it's coming up. We'll give it that.
Yeah, where's the medic? Oh, there he is. I see him.
He was in there somewhere.
Probably would have been preferable to get the medic on the other side of the thing. Yeah. Okay.
I don't see any route. Everybody have an agent.
Yeah, another agent showed up to the wrong place due to jammies.
Yeah.
Get lost.
That fixes that.
No, yep. I was just double checking.
All right.
If we need, I can bring the truck around. We can get her to a roadway.
Let's see where to go with this.
I mean, we can just go down there and go up. That, yeah, I think it should be tip-down.
Yeah, I did like your OC.
Hear me out.
Yeah.
There's a, there's a roadway back there that I could pull a medic onto, and we could load up there so we don't have to go down. Work smarter, not harder.
I mean, it's probably going to take as much time as we just going to walk there. Probably could just get her a medic.
Okay. Yeah. Let's just do that then.
And they're busy deciding how to get me to the ambulance, so they're confused.
Alright, Jenny, we're gonna get ready to move you to the ambulance, okay?
Mm-hmm. I gotta still find some lights that aren't blinding for this.
Yep.
Police lights. I don't even know, like, the ones I've tried are all blinding.
Yeah, really?
Alright, you count.
Yeah.
Alright, one, alright, two.
It's just the visual settings file. That thing, you know, for the police lights. I just keep getting shit once.
Anybody gonna grab me or am I walking?
Alright, let's get her over to the ambulance.
Apparently I'm walking again. Where am I going? I don't even know how I'm going.
Shallower
this way.
Jimmy pulls up.
Yeah. We're going a bit of a long walk.
Jenny, you still with me?
Yeah, I am.
Long term for
that's shallow there.
I didn't give her any pain medication. We have possible head injury.
Okay. I could do with pain medication. It's really sore.
At this point, we have an IV with atropine. We have a tourniquet on the left leg due to a femoral bleed. And we also have a splinted right arm.
Need painkillers? No? We don't do painkillers.
Head injury.
If you want, I'll go with you. I was going to say, if you go with 244, I'll just check, I can clear up here.
The known painkillers because of head injury isn't
alright,
yeah,
you guys.
235, stay with the patient because you were the one treating her.
Alright, you got it.
In case anything.
Only with severe head injuries, I'm not showing any signs of concussion, I know my own name, so... It's less of a concern. When a person doesn't show concussion index, then you really can push pain meds.
as I was.
Right there. Someone else get in the freaking ambulance so I can get in. Thank you.
Good. We lost another engine.
Yay.
Well, oh no, what happened?
My rescue's at least better part. Okay.
We'll see you at a hospital.
Yep.
Well, hopefully you guys enjoyed that scene. A little bit something different. We wanted to make it look good for them. It's always the biggest driving force for me when it comes to creating accent scene is making it look good for the people responding to the scene. So yeah, we could do things dynamically one time and whatever happens, happens. But when the vehicles are sitting there, it looks crappy for people turning up. So I like to give people atmosphere with my scenes. I see the Civ role as that of a DM in this regard. So yeah, hopefully they enjoyed it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it too. And I will see you next time because Jenny now has no home. Which means Jenny is back on the streets. So Return to Classic Jenny is now. Thanks for watching. Bye.